The oversized material is taken out on a conveyor into a water bath. The principle of the water bath is the heavy material like stones, pieces of metal, fall to the bottom and it's conveyed to a chipper, and the chipper reduces that to under 50 millimetres. So your three streams of wood have actually now been cleaned completely. Ferrous metals, non-ferrous metals, plastics, stones, sand, grit, pieces of glass have all been removed. At that point we have material under 8 millimetres at 5% moisture ready for pressing. The other ingredient then that is used in the process is we use a NEMUF melamine urea formaldehyde resin, the suitable ammonium sulfate hardener. These materials are stored in bulk tanks. They're actually metered through smaller tanks and pumps and measuring system, commonly known as the glue kitchen. So after this, the material is then conveyed to the press lines. The material actually feeds by gravity down through the metering system at the start of the press. The extrusion press has got a pre-compressing chamber operated from the side, and it's got a single hydraulic ram from the back. The shape of the block being produced is in the continuous mould coming out from the machine. So you've got a continuous block coming at a speed of approximately 2.5 metres per minute. This block is then fed through an automatic inline sawing machine. Standards that apply to pallet blocks, they're varied, but the main one that applies in Europe is the EPAL standard. This is applied to all Euro pallets. EPAL issued the license to both pallet block makers and indeed to pallet makers as well. Following cutting, the blocks are checked in line for height, which is the most critical dimension, and the weight gives you the density. Any blocks outside of the set parameters are rejected. The reject rate is approximately 1%. This is the only plant, as far as we're aware, in the world that has online checking. In addition to this, 4 samples are taken off each line every hour, and these are checked in the laboratory. And all of the dimension checks, nail retention checks, water swell tests, these are all done on these blocks and they're recorded. So if anybody afterwards wants to see what blocks we produced on a particular date, what the tests were, we can do this.
The LIFE program in Ireland and the UK is managed by Australia. Our project officer visits us at least once a year, or often if requested. And during this visit, we discuss any problem that arise with the project, and they give us every assistance to resolve these problems. If it weren't for the assistance that we received from the LIFE programme, it's doubtful that this project would have gone ahead. The benefits to the Macroom area are substantial. It will add in excess of 2 million to the local economy on an annual basis. There are several spin-off industries, transport companies who will transport the raw materials to the factory and take the finished goods all over Europe. When in full production, Aeroblock hope to employ in excess of 50 people, which is substantial in a rural area like Macroom.